Isn't it?
It's it.
Yeah. What were you doing? You were cutting trees, were you?
I was at the top of an A-frame ladder, the very top.
Yeah.
I saw I was falling.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was.
Yeah. And you landed how? Onto your like feet like this or onto your side?
I think it was onto my side. Sort
of. Yeah. Okay. And we'll cut all your clothes off. We'll keep you in the ambulance so you're warm for now. Okay, buddy.
My first impression of Seb is a man who is in a lot of pain, is not breathing quite normally, either because of his injury or because of his pain, and a man who is very scared, and that worries me.
Do you mind if while I just do a primary survey?
Not everybody looks that scared after they've had an injury. So yeah, it's a sign of something bad going on.
Someone tries to pop in another cannula. Yeah, we're going to get you really warmed up now and we're going to give you loads of painkillers, okay, mate?
Sam needs to find the source of Seb's pain to work out what's going on inside.
Have a gentle feel of your tummy. Yeah, everywhere.
When I pressed his tummy, he was desperately tender and rigid, which can be a sign of a real disaster going on in the abdomen.
If I press here, does that hurt?
Down here,
hurting down there when I'm pressing here, yeah. Seb, I'm just undoing your trousers to have a look at your pelvis.
Paramedic Simon Probert is concerned about the risk of internal bleeding.
With all trauma patients that we attend, we'll always perform an examination of the pelvis. It's a very, very strong, rigid structure, but it can be broken. Because of the amount of blood vessels that sit within your pelvis, pelvic fractures can be fatal. They can be life-threatening, and you can lose your entire blood volume within your pelvis without any external bleeding.
Does that hurt your back?